Hey, it's me again. All right. So when you're working with products, you have all those parts inside of it, right? But then you also have subassemblies. Now, subassemblies are like doors, drawers, drawer boxes, other things like that. So we haven't really gone too much into subassemblies, but that's what we're going to start doing in this video. We're going to be working with subassemblies, learning how to make some modifications, and then some of those different save options that you have too. Okay, so let's continue working in this new kitchen project and get into this next training exercise. So we're in our new kitchen again, picking back up where we left off. We already made some changes to the local products and a couple to the project settings, but now we're going to dig into it a little bit deeper and go into our subassemblies. So let's change our view. Let's hide a couple of these objects. Okay, so now we're not ready to send off any drawings yet until we dig a little bit deeper inside of these cabinets and make some more changes to what we call our subassemblies. So for example, this door needs to be a glass door. Some other things that we want to change with maybe our fillers or toe kick skin down there, we got to close up that gap. So we're going to go through a few things on how we can work with our subassemblies and get these products updated so we can start putting together some shop drawings. Now to start, I'm going to go into this blind corner cabinet. So in our last video, we set this up where we have this blind fascia panel flush with the door on the corner cabinet. And now because I want to bring all these fillers flush to the other doors inside of this project, we're going to make some changes. I could go back into this product and just update our blind corner width. But instead of doing that, I'm going to utilize our global variable that we have and set this project to have fillers flush with faces. So to do that, I'm going to go into the next product to the left, this upper one glass door cabinet. Make sure that we have our right filler turned on. So currently we have it set up in our project where it is set back to the cabinet box. Now we are going to change it at the project level, but because we're going to be working with subassemblies, first thing I want to do here is go into the scribe filler inside of the product and show you where that prompt is living. So selecting the prompts of this cabinet and now right clicking in the open space, we can show subassemblies. And this will take us to the list of the subassemblies that we have inside of this product. And there's our scribe filler that we're going to work on. Now right click and show subassembly prompts. And there we have this flush with face prompt that we can check. Now, because this is a global variable, we can turn it on at the project level, but just wanted to show you where that is. So if we only want one filler to be flush here, we can do it here and not affect any other fillers inside of the project. The other way to get to subassemblies through the prompts is in this menu. There's our subassemblies. It takes us to the same page. Okay, so now we're going to go into our global variables inside of our project specification groups. And I don't know exactly where this variable is, so I'm just going to start typing in F5 pretty quickly. Takes us down to our list, looking for something called fillers. There we go, fillers flush with faces. Then once we hit OK, it'll take us down to that category where that variable is. Scroll down without hitting anything in that open space yet, so we can keep that highlighted blue. Check that. Now back into our drawing, we can redraw these products. So we'll have the uppers, sink cabinet. Now, before we do that, I noticed that we still have the same issue going on this blind corner cabinet. So I'm just going to take a moment here, turn off that corner filler, and we don't need to go through this again. So I'll just speed through this and make these changes in the background, and the magic of TV, we'll have a new cabinet with our updated fillers. And done. All right, so that's good. As we redrew that cabinet, changing that filler width, you can see it's already bringing it flush to the face of those drawers because of that global variable turned on. So given that's the condition, we want to make sure that we have our reveal set up right. Under face options, you'll notice here that we have that right reveal in red, so it's formula driven, but understands as soon as we have that filler flush with face turned on inside of the project or the product, that right reveal amount will update. So one thing I wanted to point out just to show that these cabinets are smart enough, a lot of these formula driven values are working behind the scenes, so you don't have to. All right, okay, now moving on and get into our next cabinet. Now we can go through and select our cabinets. Drawer stack's already done. Hey, just jumping in here to make sure you're not falling asleep. Everything's going good? Cool. Let's keep up the good work and get back into training. Okay, we got our fillers now flush with the faces. That looks good. I can see right there that we don't have our top gap on these fillers. So if you're asking how we would do that, we can go into our subassembly prompts, right, by right clicking in that open space and going through that way. But there's a faster way to do it, and that's going to be going into the Modify tab and into Modify Subassemblies, Show Subassembly Prompts. And then just making sure that we are selected on a subassembly. So we know that filler is one. We can select that. And takes us right into our prompts. There's that flesh with face. Now that prompt turned on because of the global variable. And here's the height. I'm just going to take off an eighth of an inch on that. I'm going to 29 and 7/8. So now we have that top gap matching up with the height of our doors. All right, so I guess this is the point of video where I jump in and call myself out. I'll call this corrections and retractions. So when using the show subassembly prompts and go directly into the subassembly, when we change it to 29 and 7/8, we didn't see any kind of red formulas in here, so there's no way to tell that this is a formula-driven value or not. Now, it's fine to change it in here. It's not going to be a problem. Just something to keep in mind when working with subassemblies and going through the subassembly prompts, there may be a time that you don't see these values as a formula. Now, one way around that is just by going through the regular prompts page and then right-clicking into subassemblies. And now you can see some of the subassemblies that are being used have some prompts from the local level that are driving that information. Well, like I said, still not a big deal. If you want to update it in here, just remember that any changes to the project level with updating the upper cabinet heights will not affect the scribe filler. That one is going to be hard valued now at that current height. You can see there, even though it's still red, by selecting on it, we've stomped on that formula. Okay, you good? Everything making sense? Cool. All right, let's get back into it. So now moving on to the next subassembly that I want to work on, and that's our adjustable leg subassembly and that kickskin. So going right into that subassembly part again, and now into the kick front options tab. The amount to extend the right toe kick, it's already looking to the filler amount, so it knows that it needs to extend it at least that much, but I want it to go a little bit further into that next cabinet. So we have our toe kick recess amount that we need to add. Now, remember, we don't want to overwrite formulas if we don't have to. So one way that we can keep this formula intact is by right-clicking in the cell, showing formula, and then just adding a value to the end of this. So we have our toe kick recess set up to 2 inches. Now, if we don't want to have a hard value here and we actually want to use a name, like a prompt name or a global variable name, we have this option down here to select from global variables, local variable. You can see all the different ones up there. Anyway, going down to our toe kick recess. I know there's one in here. See, toe kick front offset base cabinets. So now hitting OK, you can see that's brought in our global variable. And now whatever we set up that value inside of our project, it'll carry over into this prompt inside of the subassembly. Just make sure you hit apply formula. And now 5 1/8 is our amount we're extending that part. So that's how you close up that gap, and we're ready to move on to the next subassembly in this project, which is this upper door on our blind corner cabinet. Now, I'm sure we're going to get called out on that by our customer if we don't show that's a glass door. So let's do the same thing, going into the subassembly prompts, selecting our door, and turning on glass door. Now, you'll notice as we're saving these subassemblies, they're only saved to the current row. And that's within the spreadsheet or the worksheet of these products and subassemblies. We have different options to save them to the product or project level, but we're going to get into that in another video. For right now, let's just focus on saving these to the current row. So far, everything's looking good. I think we're close to the end of this video, and we can now get to working on our shop drawings and submit this to our customer. Once we do that, we'll get it back with some red line markups and then go through on cleaning it all up, making sure that it's ready to send out to the shop for production. So let's wrap it up here, and I'll see you in our next video.